Here I am with my HP 15 laptop once again, and I have to say I'm still proud of this red display cover I put in. The original one was black if you haven't seen my other video about HP 15 laptop after 3 years. Although I prefer black electronics, this red display cover looks gorgeous. And yes, this is still my main computer for now. In this video I'll show you it running macOS 10.14 Mojave. But anyway, before turning it on, we have to plug in my little Wi-Fi USB adapter, because the internal Wi-Fi of this computer doesn't work on macOS. And then we can turn it on. We'll select macOS. My main OS in this computer is still Windows 10, but there's not much to say about that. So we'll boot up to macOS Mojave. Usually it's a bit quicker than this, but it's still pretty fast. And here it is. I haven't used macOS in this computer for a while. I turned it on once, shortly after 2019 began, but then I never turned it on again, so we'll see. Here's the system information. Previously I had macOS 10.12 Sierra on this computer. I skipped High Sierra. And when I went to install Mojave, I formatted the second partition in the hard drive of this computer, or in this case, a solid state drive. And I formatted it as APFS. And it installed fine without harming my Windows 10 partition, even though I had backed it up. And in the Clover configuration file, I decided to change the Mac information from MacBook Pro to MacBook Air, just to differentiate it from my real MacBook Pro. It doesn't change anything apart from the writing here. Display is still the same. The real MacBook Air has a 1366 by 768 display in the 11-inch model, I think. Storage, I have a smaller partition for macOS compared to Windows, because Windows is the one I use more often. System 85 gigabytes, that's weird. I also tried macOS in my real MacBook Pro from 2009, but on that computer I went back to macOS 10.11 El Capitan, the latest version that's supported on it, just because I want that computer to work as well as possible. These days, I only use macOS on this computer for video editing, with iMovie. I'm not going to open it right now because my iMovie library is stored on my external hard drive. I also installed Firefox because that's my main web browser these days. And of course, the simple blue wallpaper is actually the dynamic wallpaper. The one that becomes darker during the evening and at night. I installed this application called Carabiner, not sure how you pronounce that, but that allows me to finally adjust the brightness. I have to hold down Fn, but with F2 and F3, now I can adjust the brightness finally. And volume with F7 and F8, those already worked before, and I don't have to hold down Fn for those. I didn't just have to install Carabiner, I also had to patches. I used some new kext files. Kext means kernel extension. I'll put a link to download all the files I've used to get this computer working with the Clover EFI bootloader, including my config.plist files, so you can try it on your own computer. This computer has an Intel Core i7-4510U processor. This computer also has an NVIDIA GeForce dedicated graphics card, but that doesn't work under macOS. The integrated graphics and this processor are still pretty good for iMovie. I can edit 1080p at 60 frames per second videos on this computer, and it's fast enough, it's pretty usable. I can actually do that on my 2009 MacBook Pro too, but that's way too slow, so on this computer it's a lot better. There's not much else to say. The sound works too, using Voodoo HDA. It's not very loud. I tried some workarounds, but it's still quite quiet. There's terminal in the dock there, because with all the hacks I have to do on Hackintosh. I use terminal macOS more than Linux. For example, if I have to mount the EFI partition to edit files for Clover and stuff like that. See, that's the last command I've typed. But first I have to make the directory volumes EFI and then mount it like this. In my case, the EFI partition is at disk 0s6, but for most people it's gonna be instead of 6, it's gonna be a lower number. You have to check using diskutil list. Wow, I've never seen this before. Disk 1 synthesized. So now not only do we have synthesized sounds, but also synthesized volumes, like disks. But anyway, this is the real SSD in this computer, disk 0, and the EFI partition is here, disk 0s6. It originally was one of the first ones here, but when I installed Windows 10 on this computer, the EFI partition was only 100 megabytes, which is not enough for macOS, so I had to delete that partition and make a new one after the Windows partition, and I made it around 300 megabytes, and that works fine for both Windows and macOS. To change resolutions on the fly, I used this application called RDM, which I believe means Retina Display Monitor, something like that. Retina Display something, I don't remember exactly. I usually use the native resolution, but I can also use an impossibly grainy resolution on the screen. Look at that, that's 2600 by 1440. Let's switch to 1080p. That's not much better. Or we can switch to a high DPI resolution, like a real Retina display. Of course, it's not gonna look sharp on this screen, but we can do, for example, 1280 by 800 high DPI, which is double of that, which is 2650 by 1600, I think. And because everything is twice as big, it's a bigger resolution. I prefer using the native one. It's low, but it's the best for this computer, really. Or actually the best for this display. I know it's really bad, but like at least it works. It's better than no display at all. Sleep mode still doesn't work. Plugging in external displays over HDMI still doesn't work. I tried various times to patch the SSDT or DSDT, something like that. I've read everything about it, but all my attempts failed. Like, it basically did nothing. I guess I'm not good enough at doing this stuff. But again, I don't do much on this computer, so I'm fine with its flaws. The main operating system on this computer is Windows 10, which is not my favorite version, but it's updated and works fine. So until the next macOS version comes out, I have an updated Hackintosh, which mostly works fine and works perfectly fine for what I need it to do. Of course, if you want to try this on your own computer, you have to read the guide Booting the macOS Installer on Laptops Using Clover. It teaches you how to make a macOS install USB drive and then install the Clover bootloader on it and all the appropriate kernel extension and configuration files. As I said, I'll give you my files so you can try this if you have a computer that's very similar to mine, if not the same. But it's not a really easy process, and you could screw up your Windows installation if you're trying to dual boot. So if you just want to try macOS just to check out its differences compared to Windows, I suggest you use a virtual machine instead. It's slower, but it'll work. So thanks for watching.